This week on Maker Update, the latest in lightsaber tech, a new batch of CNC tools, a drippy dress, and a time traveler's timepiece. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. I hope you're doing well. I've got a fun show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. To me, there's nothing better than a project that shows me something unexpected. With one exception, I do love when a maker is so obsessed with a project that they can't help but revisit it and refine it year after year. The Ruiz brothers have made a number of DIY lightsaber builds over the years. With each one, not only does the design get better and easier to reproduce, but the technology also gets more streamlined and capable. Two things I found remarkable in their latest revision on Adafruit. First, the hilt design, which borrows from the snap fit construction of their previous version, but uses a much cooler looking illuminated power switch. Also, this time around they had the hilt professionally printed in resin and sanded smooth. Not only does it look so much nicer than the telltale layer lines of their previous versions, but according to them, the service only cost around $30. The other remarkable bit here is that the electronics have been boiled down to a single board that can handle the LED animation, motion feedback, audio playback, and audio amplification. The board is the Adafruit RP2040 Prop Maker Feather with I2S audio amplifier, and it runs around $20. So not only is this the best lightsaber design we've seen yet from the Ruiz brothers, but it's the least expensive and the easiest to build. I love it, and there's a lot to learn from it in terms of both the 3D design and the code. You can find the full guide using the link in the description. Now for some news. There's been a quiet surge of new CNC tools making their debut. I figured I'd run through them quickly. First, the Maslow 4 Full Plywood Sheet CNC Router. This is an update to a popular, absurdly affordable design that came out 6 years ago. Aside from the price, which is currently around $525, the other part of the appeal here is that it's oriented on its side, which makes for a smaller footprint. The design has seen a ton of improvement. It's all open source, and the interface is all browser-based, so there are no proprietary apps to update. Arguably, a design like this isn't going to be as precise as an expensive horizontal gantry-style system, but as an entry point for doing large-scale CNC cut signs and furniture, it seems really appealing for the price. Also on Kickstarter right now is this desktop CNC lathe called Round. This one is in the $5,000 to $8,000 range, but it's a much different category of tool. There are tools like the Bantam for desktop milling, but a desktop CNC lathe is relatively unheard of. To sweeten the deal, you can also outfit this thing with a laser engraver. For the right project, I could see the appeal, but it's definitely in the early days for this tech in a hobbyist configuration. For a company on the other side of the Kickstarter CNC tool journey, there's Glowforge, who have a new entry-level laser cutter called the Aura. It's priced at just $1,200, and if I'm being honest, I'm a little hurt that they're not even marketing it towards me. Instead, they're being sold at Michael's and Joann craft stores and really going after the Cricut craft audience. That said, for the price and the footprint and the ease of use, I'm kind of curious about this thing. Now for more projects, another hit from the Adafruit crew, this time from Aaron St. Blaine. Check out this beautiful LED animated dress. Aaron calls it the Water Drip Dress with Ooze Master 3000. The Ooze Master bit is a reference to some simulated liquid physics LED animation code written by Phil B back in 2019 and intended more as a Halloween prop effect. But Aaron has ingeniously repurposed it here as more of an enchanted water effect. And you have to appreciate that a simulated physics effect like this requires some relatively powerful processing to pull off. In Erin's case, she's using the Adafruit Feather RP2040 Scorpio board, which is optimized for driving addressable LEDs. You can check out the full guide on Adafruit. One project that really surprised me this week was this Back to the Future clock from Jerome95 on Instructables. It's kind of out of nowhere. Jerome is new to me with what looks like a pretty new channel. Back to the Future is a great film, but not really topical at the moment, And honestly, I tend to swipe past clock projects just because there are so many of them. But in spite of all that, it's just a great, fun, well-designed project. The logo looks fantastic, and the gradient effect is created just by using LED strip. That design trick alone is worth giving this project your attention. He also did a great job recreating the look of the Time Machine clock. In this case, it's pulling down the current time over the internet, and he includes the Arduino code for making it happen. Also, if you're just interested in the logo bit or just interested in the Time Machine bit, he has separate projects that tackle each in more depth. This is really more like a mashup of his other projects, but I think it's a great idea. Now for a few tips and tools. From Cuddle Labs, there's an online keychain generator that they can't legally call a Barbie keychain generator, but I mean, see for yourself. You'll need a paid account in order to download the generated files, but it may be worthwhile if you wanted to make a batch for the Barbie fans in your life. On printables, check out this retro wedge computer case design by Andy MT. It's made for a full-size keyboard to just drop in, though you may need to make some adjustments for your preferred keyboard. And on his YouTube channel, Mr. Innovative shows off a design he made for an automatic header pin cutting machine. For those of you who batch out electronic kits, something like this could be a real help. Plus, what's better than having a robot that helps you build robots? For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, check out the playlist for Potentially Genius. In each episode, you get a real sense of what it's like for a design team to take a product idea from concept to prototype. And it's not just about the engineering, it's about process, teamwork, and interaction design. Sometimes it's even about helping your client figure out what they're actually asking for. It's a great show, and I always come away from it inspired. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. A big thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.